Hello and welcome to Dell's Gaming. I'm Dell and you join me here in From the Depths, where I'm going to go into the designer because there's a lot of changes happening to From the Depths at the moment, and Nick the designer's working very hard at getting lots of little changes coming in. Some major changes to Unity and some other parts, but because of the big changes to the floor depth and other areas, I thought I'd do a couple of building videos and some testing before we get back into the campaign. Partially because I've had lots of people saying, well, you know, how do I build submarines, and my submarines are quite good, so I want to go through the process of building a submarine on a video. And also I need to modify some of the ships to be more starter ships. I'd modified a lot of the ships to make them very expensive for later on in the game, and I now need some which are slightly lower resource levels. So we'll go into the designer, so join me when we are settled in the designer menu. Hello and welcome back. My little scuttlebot has got a slightly different view on the bottom. He's no longer got that foot on it. I think it was causing some problems, so he's got a nice little jet below him, which I think is quite cool, actually. Okay, back to our building. So, as is normal, what am I going to build? Right, so the way I think about it is that we need to... I want a submarine. Obviously, we're building a submarine. And we'll go through the process I'm thinking of. Now, my design, or what I like to do, is think about what I'm going to build first. And what I'm after is a fast, small, fast submarine. Smallish, you know. It's going to have some weapons in it. It is going to be, you know, missile armed, because that's what I do. I like my missiles and I like having lots of missiles, so it'll be a missile armed submarine, torpedoes and some missiles for attacking surface and air targets. It's not going to go very deep. It will go down to maybe about 35-40 meters will be our aim, rather than going to the very bottom of the depths. But the main criteria will be speed. Now, generally, excuse me, a little sip of coffee there. Most of the submarines that get built end up with a speed between as low as 5 up to about 10 as a maximum. I think I've seen on the ship, maybe a little bit higher on occasion. I would like to get a submarine, see if I can get a submarine around the 15 to 20 mark. So it's going to make some design constraints. But generally that should be okay. So without further ado, let's go into build mode and we're going to start a new vehicle, new object, a vehicle. Let's just go and set up that first block, thank you very much, and put it up into the sky. Right, now we will start using some metal blocks. Now, one thing, if for those that don't look after the go into the From the Depths form, there's been some testing between blocks versus beams. Now, which is better for frame rates and the rest of it? And there, it has been found that beams do use less power, basically, than singular blocks. And I've done that wrong, because the front of the ship, this is an important factor. Where is the front of the ship? The front of the ship is that way. Okay, I just wanted to make sure I wasn't building sideways. You do have to watch out for this. When you lay that first block, make sure that you go in the right direction. There's been a lot of people have built ships backwards or sideways by accident, because they didn't keep an eye on the arrow of the block when they first built, and they started like making this the front of the ship, whereas if you look at the arrow that's just above on this block's not great for seeing it. Let me just get a smaller block. You can see the arrow on the block. Make sure you always keep that facing forwards, otherwise your ship's going to be a bit weird when you've finished with it. Okay, so sorry, I was saying that there's been some testing that's found that beams are much better than blocks for frame rate. So if you're building a big area, try to make it of beams. Right, so let's start with the basics of the ship and what are going to be my prime requisites. So first thing to think about is I always start with the armaments of the ship and then work back through to the AI engines and then finally sort out the movement and work it back through that way, because those, especially on a sub, you want to keep it looking a little subby, so you know, that sort of circular type of view to it, like a cylinder. Now one good thing, there's no pressure, so you don't have to build a true cylinder like in the real world. As my rays and some of my other ships have shown, you can basically build a submarine or a ship in any shape you want and just force it through the water. One element we do have to think about here, and we just do a little bit of a testing here, is that because we are wanting to make this fast, we have to think about the size and its frontal area. And what I'm just doing here is, I'm going to go back into this mouse wheel, I prefer this rather than doing this sort of thing, is how big an area has, the frontal area has on the ship. Because this is a physics model game, when it's working out speeds, it looks at how much frontal area you have. So basically your drag, think of a car, and a car has a certain amount of drag associated with it. So if we go there, now if we imagine this is the front of the ship, so this is the layout of the front, which has given us a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 height, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 width. So it's slightly tall, which is fine. If we now go into the V here, we can see, we should be able to see, in theory. It's not showing anything now. Is that because I have it in this mode here? Oops, come off. The more area you've got on the front, the more drag you're going to effectively have. So it's difficult to show here because we're not actually showing any of, we haven't got any power pushing us forward, unfortunately. So I was hoping I could show those figures without it having propulsion, etc. So the front of this vehicle has, I wonder if this will just do it. This is going to be a bit weird, but I wonder if this will just show the figures, even though it's a jet engine. I don't care in a second. Right. Does that give us the figures I'm after? No, it's not giving us the figures. But basically, the larger this frontal area, we'll see it later on, but the larger the frontal area we have, the more drag it will have, and therefore the more resistance to going forward. So we want to make this frontal area effectively as small as possible, and that will increase our speed. So with that in mind, we've got to think about our weapons. Now I'm thinking of two weapon systems. One is going to be a torpedo system. So the torpedo, front torpedo system, might be about an 8-block torpedo, so quite large. Okay, just finished up a little phone moment there, such is life. Right, okay, so where were we talking about? Okay, let's start with the offensive capabilities. So that's going to set up how big and what this is going to be. So let's, what should we go for with this? I have a hankering for some bloody great big torpedoes. So fitting out the front, just a couple of them. So that's going to define the front. So I'm going to have, if we say this is going to be the base level, oops, I want to have that back here. We're going to have some missile torpedoes and coming out the front. 3, 4, 5, 8, 9, 10. I'm going to go for some monsters, some complete and utter monster missiles. There we go. That looks good to me. Totally oversized. Why not? So 12 block missiles, and they're going to have lots and lots of HE or fragmentation, and I might even make them attack things underwater. We'll have a think about that. But they're just going to be like completely and utterly oversized for no apparent reason. We'll sort that out. So that's going to define that. We'll need a missile controller and a, say, friend and foe and a stagger. Whoops, don't want that. This is where the mirror works against me. Don't want that mirror now. Let's turn the mirror off. Put it on there. Okay, we'll need that. And then what else would we need? We would need, put a couple of ejector add-ons just on that, just to make sure they push out nicely. There we go. And we would need a missile controller on the top, a AI weapon controller. There we go. I know we're going further ahead than we need to at this second. Okay, I'm gonna have to put it down here. There we go. There, with a wireless on the top, wireless receiver on the top. Okay, so that's gonna define that side. So if we put a little couple of blocks here just to mark out the end, and then we would build that up. Right, and then what's next? Now, looking at this, if we had this going across here at that height, I'm just thinking of having our command area and the AI near the front. So if we had that going back forwards, let's see, I need to take out that one, I think. Yeah, I should have put my mirror line back on. Yes, okay. We could potentially put our control chair, if we're going for this size area, put a control chair there. But potential. We'll have a think about that in a minute. We'll do the other bit. We'll leave a bit of space, I think. But that's a potential possibility. Or even here, just have these blocks actually running at this height here. Okay, let's just put them down in here. There's no need for them to be that high up. We can have them down in here. And this becomes our control and AI area about this level. Yeah, we've got possibility. Right, so next, let's just not get too ingrained in that. So we have might have our control, our chair and everything near the front. A little different to normal. Alternatively, we can have our chair and everything just in this little area here, and we'll plan for that. So we would need control chair, few control blocks. So let's say we leave that area for our command area. So, and we're gonna have, this is a very sleek system, so we're not gonna have many counting towers and maybe not even have any way of seeing out. So we'll see on that. Right, next, the next section would be our secondary missiles. So these are going to be vertical launch missiles. Now, they're going to be close range. So let's think this through. From underwater, from our tests we did in the previous lab video, I know it will work with four blocks. So let's go with a four block missile system. Missile launch pad going straight up. There we go. How many should we have? It looks like we're going to need some more blocks. We don't need some more blocks here. So obviously we don't need to extend this out a bit further. So here we are, we're laying down the basis of our ship still. Da, 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 da. And then we can adjust it later on once we've done. Okay, I'm going a little further than I need to here, but I've got engine and everything else I've got to think about here. So, okay, where did we get to? Eight missiles. So we've got seven. Now let's get that back up again. So that's one, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 missiles there. Let's go a few more. I think we need more than 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 missiles. So we don't have a vertical 12 missile launch area, straight up. Yes, okay, so now we'll need to put the missile blocks on here. So these are going to be fast firing, so it's going to be 12 fairly fast firing missiles we'll have, that she'll just come out of the water and aim at whatever target we've we're aiming at, quite simply. So they'll just fire as needed. I'm not going to set up the missiles just at the moment. We're still just at that point of setting up where everything is going to go. Now, what we will also need to do is we will put an ejector on everyone. Yes, I think that would be a wise decision. So there we go. There's a quick little ejector. There we go. And then obviously we've got to put, I say obviously, we need six connectors to connect all of these missiles together to the end. And we're going to put that onto the end as well, because this is where we're going to put our controllers. So next we're going to need a missile controller. Now, to save a bit of space, we're going to see if we can, no, okay, let's just put it here then. A little longer than I wanted. You can, actually, let's try this. If we go our six-way connectors up here, we can now put our various control parts on this vertical, and it'll save a little length. Won't take up too much space. So okay, this controller just there. We will then put above it, we can put a friend and foe, and above that we can put our stagger. And we'll set our stagger at about 0.3 there. And then we would need our AI controller just here. Don't have to have it pointed in the right direction, but it's nice to have it that way. And the wireless receiver. Okay, now we don't have any AI yet, but we'll sort that all out later. We've already thought we can put this the AI over here or maybe in here. Right, so that's the end of that area. Let's again block it off. Now that's defined our height. So as we can see, or just about see, that means that that block there, I think it was, let's just get some blocks, is our max, our theoretically is as tall as we would need to go for most of our ship. Let's just confirm that, bring this over here. If we have the tops of these vertical launch missiles basically flush with the top of the ship, we could make them recessed, and I might just give some sloped blocks just so that they've got a one depth and protected a little bit from missiles. If we get shots coming in straight, This is one reason I don't like these ones. As you're heading towards someone, if you've got shots coming down, they'll go down and damage these missiles. We don't have to go with that. We'll potentially, I think, get some sort of little shield up just to go against the top to protect against that type of problem. But otherwise, okay, that's correct. So now we've defined, for missiles at least, for our weapons systems, what is our maximum size? We could pull this in a little bit. So the next stage is engines. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to define a little bit of space for our ammunition storage. So double wall thickness, 1, 2, 3, and then another double wall. So that's where we'll put our ammo barrels for our ship. Right, next, engines. So engines is our next part of the ship. So I'm elongating it a little bit more. Now, power-wise, I haven't worked out propulsion yet, but I'm thinking we're gonna need a fair bit of propulsion to get this getting up into a good speed. So we're gonna need about 300 power to get propulsion. Then I'm gonna want a couple of shields. Certainly on the top here, covering these missile bays, and maybe one at the front. Not too big, you know, a sloped one at the front. So as they're charging in, any of the heavy cannon shots will just bounce off the system. Most probably at this moment won't bother with side shields. We'd potentially just go for top. We'd only try and use speed and the fact that we're underwater, so we'll go with that. So I'm looking at, we need about 600 power is a potential. So let's go to our engines. Now we're going to build the engine backwards, so we're going to start here and then build some crankshafts. Now I might go for one of my raised designs, but one reason is because of this shape of we've got where it's out, we're going to have a little bit more room about mid-level. That's potentially too many engines, so but I'm putting more than I need in at this stage. So the next stage, this is one of my left and right connector, we'll put the mirror line on because that'll be handy now. Okay, so we'll start with a single engine at the back, then we put that and then that, and we'll try it with a three side, then we put a cylinder in and there, whoops, wrong place, there, there. Now I don't want this too wide, so it won't be as efficient as it could be, so let's try that, see how much power we're going to get out of that config. Now carburetors, one in the center between each of those groupings, then between them. Now I could have it so it sticks out, and then finally height. Have we got still got room to go up? Yes, we have got room to go up on this. If we get extra power, so how much room have we got here? We can go, if we go across here, we can go two across theoretically. If we, is that that this height? So that's going to make it bulge out a little bit. If I started to add here, we're going to have a wider, it's going to be lower but wide because of these engines. That's interesting. So we've got three, we can go, if I get out to there, two, I could go three out, I think. So this is possibly going to define the width of our engine. By the looks of it, this the engine is going to define the width of our ship, and we might have it so it's the first, the bottom comes out sharply and then it slopes in near the top, so the top might be slightly more angular. No, that might be, look okay. Right, so now superchargers, let's see how much power we end up with. Superchargers in the center, and let's see, on that three and that three, there we go. Obviously we're not going to have too much power yet, 17, yep. Now we've got fuel tanks, we'll go with them. They're going in most of the other places where we have multiple carburetors. Carburetors are connecting in more than one place. And then finally on the top, which defines our maximum height of the engine. This is, it's quite a large engine really, but it does the job. I found it efficient enough. It's not the most efficient design of engine, but it does the job. Have I missed anywhere? I don't think I missed anywhere except maybe on that end. One can go on the end. There we go. All right, and we now I can put onto the very end here another three, but let's just say how much power we've got already. See if we need that. Okay, so we've got nearly 2,000 power, which is a lot more than I was predicting I need. Let's see how much that's used. So that's used a lot of metal. Is that because of that? If I take, let's take a. Do I go with the 2,000 power and just say, right, really shield this up? Or we've still got a lot of building to do on this, and we're already at 70,000 RP points. and 15,000 metal. Now, submarines are very metal hungry, because this is mainly, and we haven't even started on the metal. So I'm going to take a row of these engines. I said only 600, so let's get round. I didn't realise that would be quite so powerful, which is good in many ways, but not what I needed at this stage. So we will get rid of a few of one row. I'll tidy this up in a second. Let's see if that's closer to plan. Right, what's that now? 800. Okay, that's good. That's good. Let's just tidy this back up again. Let's find the carburetors. We'll put the carburetors back, and then we'll put the fuel tanks back. Whoops! Fuel tank. Where is the fuel tank? Thank you. There we go. So okay, that's a little bit more. What have we got? We've still got 1300, which is good, nearly 1400, and a little bit lower down on each of those. Okay, well, we'll go with that. I could make it a little more efficient, I suppose, but we'll go with that. We might take these ones, and I've still got a little bit of sight on the side here. So, okay, we've got that. So that's the engine sorted. I'll need to put some fuel tanks and processors there. And that's about it. So if we say that's going to be the rear of the ship, so we're now just block off this bit here, just as the marker of the rear of the ship, and we can now define what is the width, maximum height and maximum width. So if we're going with that, with the height, okay, and the width, it's one away. So that's going to be the width there, is one away from here, and then the hull, so we don't need that. Okay, so we can tighten this up a little bit. How high is this up? It's one, those two there, so it's up one, and then those two. So as we got here, okay, so that's about right. So there. So that's the maximum width. We take that down there. So that's now our, effectively, our frontal shape. Now, there is a reason why I'm keeping with the three at the bottom, and we'll go through that later. There's quite a few changes need to be done at the bottom with hydrofoils. I might be able to point it a little bit like that, but we'll go with the three at the moment. So that's our basic shape. So let me just continue the hull, and I'll fast forward it whilst I just fill in some of the hull points, and we'll see where we are once I have completed that. So see you shortly. Welcome back. So this is most of the ship has been created. I've just noticed something which is due to the recent patch, which I've got to sort out before we can continue, but we'll come back to that in a minute. So we've gone for the basic sort of boomer style, pointed the front. I spent a bit of time sorting that front side out and armoring it. If we go to the press P, we get all the block view. We have got an empty area in the front, which we can use for something. It's either going to be just for ballast, or we could armor it up with more metal. I put the slight raising around these missiles. Now this has two effects. One, protects the missiles a little bit. Looks good. And if I wanted to, I could add another block to make these a 5 block. If we find the 4's not good enough, or we've got problems with the 4. The ammo has double thickness beams wherever possible around it. So that should be nicely protected. 1800 with some ammo producers in there. It's not as protected as I would 100% like, but it should be defensive. We'll put some shields on there as well. Our control area, if I go back down here, our control area where we've got our chair. So we've got our chair, and we have, that block's terrible, let's just go to a smaller block. And we have our mainframes. I haven't put a wireless on top of that. Let's just sort that one out. I just suddenly saw that, transmitter. Okay, so we've got a control, and we've got a couple of automated control blocks. We will be having more automated control blocks, but they'll mainly be on the outside of the ship, and we'll explain that in the second section of this video. Now, the one bit I noticed is with the latest patch, all of my unlocks have disappeared. So if we go to water, propellers, I don't have the huge propeller. I've got to redo the mission number one. Heat decoy, same again. So I've got to go and redo all of the missions. What else is going to be affecting us? I think most probably the lamb somewhere. Laser missile defense. So I didn't realize that. Missile warner. That they're going to be done. And I do want to use the large propellers. I was going to try and fit 3 large propellers on the rear of this ship and see how it goes. Now, we could do this just with small propellers as a starting point on this ship. Let me just check the center line at the moment. It's between those two. We might sort that out in a minute. So it's actually going to be there. That's just in preparation. The center line of the ship is very important, working where that is for all of your propulsion and everything else like that. So marking where that is, in where I'm intending that to be, is very important, and we'll go into that in again in the second stage. So what I'm gonna do is, if I try to do it with the small propellers, I think we could do it. We would need a lot of them. I don't think it's going to be as effective or as fun or good looking as having a few really large propellers on the back. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to stagger them. So I'm going to have potentially one on the end here. And because you need 8 blocks in between, we're going to have one possibly in this area. Let's go to a better block. So I'll put a wooden block where I'm intending a stone block actually, where I'm intending. So the centre of one of them will be about there, and the same on the other side. Then we're going to have some blocks here, and then put the other one just there. Now hopefully that will allow three of those. Then our rudders, we will need a rudder. It also needs to be balanced. We've either got to put the rudder slightly offset, so it's above or below the center line, or we might use thrusters instead of a rudder and then put them on the side here facing outwards. So we turn the ship using thrusters rather than a rudder. Or I might just put the rudder, we could put the rudder, say, just there. That will, if I did that though there, we'll explain that when I get into ships, it will make the ship twist and turn. Alternatively, we might find that two engines is enough, and we can then put the rudder on the center line, which is another possibility. So we can effectively put it there, but we'll look at that on the sink stage. So I'm just save this ship, and we will come back once I have quickly unlocked these huge propellers. See you in a short while. Okay, welcome back. I've just quickly completed that mission. So now we should be able to, that's the deep water guard mission one you have to complete. So I should now be able to put some propellers on here. So if I put some huge propeller, there we go there, and one there. And we're going to go for the one on the rear, just there. I'm not liking the looks of that. I like the offset style, but we might shorten this. It's looking very similar to what I had on the race. I know I might be able to make this work visually. We can pull down a little bit on the top here, I think. That's just... I'm not too worried about the visuals, but that being said, I don't want it looking too off, for want of a better word. I like to have a bit of a reasonable look to it. So, okay, that's like that. Maybe I could, instead of doing these as blocks, not push them out quite so far. We will need a bit of space for balancing, which we'll get into later. When we have to use small engines just to balance the up and down part of it. So we'll leave that space there. We'll get rid of these blocks actually, those beams, and we're gonna instead just use some metal blocks to extend out this section, just like that, and then we'll put another huge propeller on the end of there. Yeah, it's not really, I mean, you wouldn't in reality have a huge propeller on the end, but I, to hell with it. Nah, I can, so therefore I am, type of situation. We'll put a little bit on here, that will tidy that up a little bit. I'm getting a little obsessive with the with putting everything in this. The blocks, they act as a sort of bit like armor, but they don't really have an effect. I want to put the corners in. I think we'll just put those in there. That will look okay. So, okay, secret with the propellers. You have to have 8 blocks of clear behind the center. So 8 blocks going out from the center point to get the power. But it doesn't need to be all the way around. It's just the center block. Right, now a couple of things I need to change on this is I haven't put yet any ballast tanks in these, which is important, because otherwise we're going to find we're not floating. Now for the moment I'm just going to put the air pumps in, because we need to make sure it does at least float. We'll put one in each of the main sections. We'll need one in here. Have we got AI missile components all the way up? Yes, we have. So, okay, we'll just put it on this side then. Let's just put it there. That's fine. And then, oh, I could have put it at the front here, actually. Never mind. We'll put one in our AI area. Okay. And we will use this front section at the moment here as another buoyancy area. There we go. Now I'm actually gonna, I think we've got a lot of extra space here which we don't need, so we're doing armor, make this armor, I think. So we're gonna put some beams in the front here and just make this an armored front, because if we're gonna get attacked, it's gonna be a lot of cannon fire and etc. shooting the front of the ship in theory. So that's just given an extra few blocks at the front, and then we've got this here acting as armor. So let's see if this floats. So the next stage of this is I'm gonna turn off the AI so it doesn't try and go anywhere, is balancing. Balancing is very important on a submarine, so that we get some sort of buoyancy, and it goes up and down. It doesn't go nose heavy or keel heavy. So first of all, we're just gonna drop it in the water and see if this thing even floats, because at 100% we want all of the air pumps at 100%. So we're gonna use one of these air control blocks just for the moment, just to simply set the air pumps. Air pumps activate on spawning at the moment, everywhere at 100%. We'll use this figure here, 100 test. Okay, so have we got floating? We have no floaty. Is it floating? Let's just see. It's rolling over, which is not good. And is that the surface? And it's not really floating. So that's a bad. So we've basically got a sinker here. Now one thing we need to do is put some ballast in the center. So we'll sort that out, the sinking part problem. We find the center and we're gonna put in some lead blocks, just to make it right up the right way. So on to there, and then we start going from the center equally. Right, so that hopefully we'll right it up. We'll bring it out of the water. So okay, we're not, two problems we have now. One, we're not floating. Two possibilities with a sub is to make it generally float by default, or make it sink by default, and then you have to force it up. Now let's see, are those air pumps, it's possibly those air pumps aren't working yet. Let's just make sure those pumps are working. So now let's see if it's done a rollover. The other thing we don't want it to do is roll over. So okay, is that now going with those lid blocks? No, we still need more weight in the bottom by the looks of it. But let's have a check on these pumps. Are they now, they are providing buoyancy in each of the areas. So that's producing 50, but it's not enough to make this float. And we can also see that it is nose heavy. So first thing we've got to do is make this float properly. Is just floating by the tail. Just by the tail. Okay, so we're gonna artificially do this. We're gonna do two things. The nose is a little heavy, so we're gonna hopefully cure this in two ways. We're gonna use some wood, which is, as you can imagine, very buoyant. So we're gonna take out some of these blocks, not the ones that are on the edge of the vehicle. Hopefully take these ones. Did it again. See any problem with this most mode, but anyway, we'll put some wooden beams. Let's see if we're we correct here, or is that, we've got a hole here for some reason. Why is there a hole just here? What should be there? Why is there a hole just there? That's one problem. If you're building these things and you get a block wrong for some reason, it can send your balance totally out. So I'm just trying to work out why that is there, because that should be a beam. Has some of the beams gone in wrong here? I'm a little worried about that. I might set my balance off. I'm going to fill it with a small block for the moment. But that should be a beam there, beam there, beam there. And we're out of sync here with beams going back. Have we got a beam difference here? Yes, we have a beam difference back here. So if we take that out, this may seem a bit, well, why bother doing this? But if you've got the different, something heavy like these beams different on the sides of the ship, on two sides of the ship, it will float strangely. It will not float as you expect it and how you want it to. So now we're putting these, let's try some wooden beams. See if we can get some buoyancy at the front of this ship. It's okay, wooden beams there though. Okay, let's see if that's gonna help at all. Looks like we're still sinking. Or are we now going up? I sort of think we're still going down. Okay, we're going up to surface. So our biggest problem at the moment is buoyancy. We has none. We is basically a stone in the water, which is not good. Not what we need at all. So we've got to find some way of making this float. Now we can use wood, which is not great. So we're going to have to make some more buoyancy tanks, some more buoyant areas. The way to do this, we can obviously just remove metal areas and make some of these areas bigger. We can extend an area or reduce it. Now it doesn't matter where the buoyancy is, that because basically the way buoyancy works, it works on the center of the ship only. It does not act on where the actual buoyancy part is. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use this underneath here to create a buoyant, an extra buoyancy area. Now what we can do is at the front, yes, is fill in this block. Oops, wrong type of block. We'll use metal on the outside because, well, this might give two areas. We're gonna, let's see, we will remove this center block here. There we go, the center section. Well, it should be okay for everything. We'll leave one just there, maybe. Even just there. Right, okay, because that might be needed. I think I don't want to take it away from somewhere where it's providing support. So there, I can't take that one out because that's all the AI. But down here, I can potentially start taking it. Take out the lead blocks for the moment. So let's go to a block that I can see a little easier with. Let's take that one out. Whoops. Is there anything on there? No, that looks like that will be okay. So, okay, going back to the front. Let's start with the front. We have that there. We're going to take another one. It went to the side, which is not what I wanted. Just there. Right, okay. Edit, metal block. Take one up. Are we into that buoyancy area? So what we're going to do now is going to make this whole front a buoyant section. There we go. So now we've got that section there going down, and then we've got these missiles. I need to just replace that part that I just accidentally took out. There we go. So we've got this section. Now we're gonna block up. So we've got buoyancy there. We take out that one there. Take out that wooden. So we've got a nice section here now. So this means that the pump is gonna act as a more buoyant area. Now we'll edit that in, and then we will fill in the bottom here. One, two, there we go. Right, is that all nicely filled in? Okay, that's filled in quite nicely now. So that's possibly has increased the buoyancy capacity of the front of that ship. I don't like that, so I'm gonna leave that one blocked in, and we'll put We'll fill in that if we need to. Now we can do the same possibly near the engine area to create a more buoyant area around near the engine. So we'll see which blocks we can take away. The crank doesn't that, yeah, we'll take that one away for the moment, take that one away. Now we need some blocks where things are, when they're built, they are resting, they need the location. So the crankshaft doesn't need that, and that doesn't need it there. Okay, so we're now at that point there. Let's just see if that makes and has an effect, beneficial effect. We'll use some blocks on the bottom of here. Okay, so we left that bit in the center. So now we've increased the buoyancy, potential buoyancy area, by making this hollow underneath. So the tank will have a larger buoyancy area. Right, so let's see. So buoyancy is now at 58. Are we going down or are we holding at 58? Well, we're sort of holding. Are we going down again? We are, we're rolling and going down. Bugger. Okay. Oh, this is the fun of these ready things. Right, we need some lead blocks. We've got to make this keel to basically balance it out and make us roll backwards again. And we're just put that in there like that, bring it upright, and see if that this time decides not to roll over. I don't want you rolling over. Right, half. You could get really ugly and just put a load of wooden beams on the top. That would stop it rolling over. But it would be ugly. It's still not wanting to roll over. So our problem at the moment is we've got a lot of buoyant, heavy blocks on the top and buoyant blocks on the bottom as far as the system is concerned. So we'll just see how far we've got to go to make it roll back over. And what I tend to do is just use lead blocks just to get it to go the right way round. So we're just seeing how far out we are from a buoyant or non-rolling system. Okay, we'll let that go down again. So this is all about weight, just distributing the distribution of the weight. So now you can see that that's, it's a little tail heavy, but is it now rolling over? It's just about resisting the roll. It's still a little front heavy. Now I'm not going to leave this with a bloody great big thing sticking out, but I've now seen how much I need to put onto this. No, it was still very tail heavy, so let's go back to here. I'm actually going to put them there instead, see if that helps to I think I need to, might need another one there, see if it, we're basically, what we're trying to do now is balance out the front and the rear. We'll work out the buoyancy in a bit, so I'm just trying to make it so it will sit level in the water, or sink level, so when it goes down, it will go down in a level fashion. And that will become important when we start working out the controls. So if this is a basically a sinker, then so be it. But we want it to sink equally. So what I'm doing is I'm balancing the blocks, front and rear, using these blocks. So it's now going down by the rear a little too much. So we'll take those two out there. I obviously did too much. Is that, where are we going now? It's now starting to roll, so we need that. That weight, that was too little weight to take off, so we're going to need, let's put, take one of those off, and we'll put a double just there, bring it up again, I always start it from just outside the water, from a fairly much a level position, and then work it out from there. So there we go, one down one more time. There we go. Right, is that the first thing? Is it rolling? No, it's fairly level. So okay, let me just balance this out and continue to do this, and you'll see the balancing process. So. Hello and welcome back. There's been a fair bit of cutting and editing because it's taken us a while to get this sort of balanced. I'm happy enough. Smaller ships, smaller subs are more difficult to balance than a larger sub, quite simply. The slightest moving one of these blocks, I'll just do that for experimentation, can make a big difference. To just removing that one block has made the whole rear of the sub go up and it start to twist. So just making one block change on a sub can make one heck of a difference. So that's what's just taken the time, is balancing all of these little components just to get them enough so that I'm happy with them. It's still not perfect, I must say. I'd prefer it to not twist as much and not be susceptible. It is generally sinking rather than surfacing, but again, that's because we've got such a small ship. We've got no spare area to put extra ballast tanks, etc. But generally, it's acceptable. For this smaller ship, the rear is slightly lighter, which is actually a preference I prefer. I'd like the rear to be up slightly. One of the reasons are for that is if you're getting hit by cannons from the front, then they'll hit at an angle. Now we'll just take this out of the water, because now we have the next part, which is controlling the depth. There's two ways of doing it. Now we'd only have one option on here. Because we haven't got a balance, we're running at 100% on our air pumps already. We can't control the ship with air pumps on this particular vessel. So we will have to control it using hydrofoils. Now hydrofoils, there's a couple of places you can put it, or a number of places you can put it. On the sides is the obvious one, at the front and the rear, or both, and have two sets of controls controlling the front and the rear. Now, what I have found myself in ships is, as soon as one side takes damage on their hydrofoils and the other side doesn't, the ship starts to spin around its axis, because these hydrofoils, for instance, if they were damaged, would not produce lift. These ones are suddenly producing excessive lift and it starts to roll. And you can start putting lots of extra controls in for that. My preference is, at the moment, or recently, has been to put the hydrofoils in the center. Now, luckily, the model of from Adepts doesn't require water to be passing over the hydrofoils, which is a bit of luck. So we can just control it with hydrofoils that are not in the water. So it also keeps the shape fairly aerodynamic. I've added some thrusters and some other little repair tentacles and bits and pieces like that, just to finish off some of the shape and what I need for control. Now, obviously, down here we've got a bit of a keel. I needed that, A, to stop it spinning, and also so I could put these blocks. By having the blocks a little bit lower, it stopped it spinning in normal, and I could, as you can see, these blocks, I've had to take quite a bit of working just to get it to balance correctly. Just moving one of those blocks just by one block position can make a heck of a difference to the balance of the ship when underwater. So let's just go and have a look at what we can do with the balancing first. Now we need a few control blocks, and I need one more, which I'm gonna put just above this pump, because that's why it's gonna be, it'll remind me it's for the pump. Right, so first one is going to be, because this sinks, we will use a control block, which, two control blocks actually, for air pumps for controlling the depth. So this one will be if it gets too deep. So if the vehicle altitude is less than let's say we're just set it 40 meters. it's less than minus 40, then set the air pump to 100%. One second delay. Now I like having a delay a little bit, so 1 second delay. Okay, so that will set to one. Now to dive, if our we're going to do the opposite. So if our altitude, where are we? If our is greater than minus, we're going to say 38. Less than 38, minus 38. Then set the air pumps, I don't like turning them off totally, to 0.1. There we go. 1 second delay. So that will just mean that what we're doing is it will do a fast dive. So when we come from the surface, it will set. We should see now that the air pumps are actually set to 0.1. Where's my AI gone? Sorry, got myself a little bit lost there. There we go. We should see these air pumps are now set to 10%, which means they're acting very little buoyancy and will help it to dive. So, and then it, once it gets down to its about its minus 38, it should slow down. So we should see a fairly fast dive. It's not going to be amazing, but it will at least help it to dive. Now, normally in a, if you've got a ship which automatically floats, you could just use those two controllers to set the height of the vessel in total, in saying, set the air pumps at 10 if high, and set it back to 100 if it's too far up. Oh, looks like the balance is a little out on that last block change. I don't know. Let's try moving that block to just there. As I say, this is a ongoing. I thought I'd got that right, but it has 100%. Okay, it's sorting itself out. That's close enough. Right, so that should, the blocks, it's getting to minus 19. They, obviously, it'll go further than we want it to here, unfortunately. Put that back where it was, actually. I think it was just a... Yeah. Changing these blocks, balancing it. I shouldn't touch it once I'd got it right. So now the height is based upon where this control block is. So height, we're at 41. So buoyancy has gone back to 100%. So that should try and make it all go a nice a level out. That must be because of the buoyancy. I wonder if they've changed the buoyancy. I'll have to change that in another test. So okay, that's starting to level out. It will continue to dive because we haven't got any other way of going it. It won't float naturally. So next stage is using the hydrofoils. So what we will do is we'll set one hydrofoil, one set here. So if we're going to use those same things. So if altitude is greater than 39. Minus 39, and it's going to affect everywhere on a 1 second delay. Set the hydrofoil angle downwards. Now we're going to start with minus 45 and see if that's just too much. And over here, we'll set if the altitude is less than, and it was 40 is our target, minus 40 is our target height, then set the hydrofoils to plus 45, so up and down. Effect range everywhere, delay, again, one. Now, for them to work, so the hydrofoils will now start to be pointing downwards. If we look at the hydrofoils here, we can see they're just pointing downwards. So, but we do need a bit of speed here. So we're gonna have to turn the AI back on. We're just gonna put it on fleet move, so the AI will try and move. And if we take it off of there, we'll just let it go forwards. And we can see it's steadily going down. That's good. Slightly nose forward. Not too bad on that. What's our speed? Our speed is going up. Okay, so now we're at minus 50. Now these hydrofoils should now be starting to point up, which they are. Is it going to start to come up again? And it started to come up again. Now, it will porpoise a little bit at the beginning. So I'm expecting it to go a bit above 30 and then come back down again. And there we go. It's coming back down again. Now I can reduce that by reducing the number of hydrofoils, but it got down fairly quick. Our speed is 7.8. Are we missing anything on the back? No, we're there. Let's see if we can get that speed up a little bit faster. If we go to force the maximum speed, which we might do a control block, under force speed we're at 13, so we might put that in. So let's see how it's like on there. So for us, we might need a speed controller. As you saw there, the computer doesn't, the AI should I say, sorry, doesn't really sort out the speed very well in my view. So we'll put a speed control block in here, and this one will simply say on spawning after 2 seconds set the speed of water to be 5. That's basically set it to maximum speed straight away. So how's our height? We're going at 29 and it's going down, so we've got a little bit too much control on our attitude controller. So what we can do is take away a few, it's almost like balancing again, we take away a few of the hydrofoils. We can always put them in again if we find we lose control and we can no longer go. We want it to, it doesn't matter if it goes up and down by a few, but we want it to hold roughly after a few seconds, we want it to hold that 38 sort of position. position. Actually having a slight porpoise isn't too bad because it makes you more difficult to hit by cannons because they'll have to be constantly correcting their fire. That's not too bad. It's 50 and it goes up a little bit and then goes down again, so I don't know, that's a little bit too much. We will take a few more hydrofoils out. Got to make sure it does have enough to go up. Going down is most probably important. It's going to go down by default. So there we go. It's going up. Okay, still a little bit much. Now the other element we can do is not have it given higher angle. So let's just do this slightly differently. So rather than giving it a plus 45, we'll say just give it plus 30. Is that enough now? Just to make sure it goes up. So it'll go down fast, up slowly. So that's going down, minus, so it's down at the minus 46. Is that now going to try and go up? See, it's not got enough angle there to go back up again. So we'll just increase that a little bit more. So one more time, oops. Similar to the balancing, this is just playing with these figures until we get something which works for us. So we're at 140 meters now. It's going down quite deep. Is it now going to start to come up? And now it's starting to come up again. Okay, so that 35 seems to be a good figure. So there's a couple of ways we can balance that. We can balance it by changing that figure to get a nice figure for the hydrofoils. If you give the hydrofoils too much, I have actually made submarines do a loop underwater by giving them too much. Oh, we have a breach. Oh, that's actually quite nice. Is it actually then go back underwater again? I quite like that. That's interesting. Coming emergency surface, and so it's going back down again, which is good. Didn't stay on the water. Quite like that. It's like a dolphin coming out of the water. Okay, it's gone down again, and then it should make its way up. Oh, this will be fun. I think this will be a fun ship. It's not perfect, to say the least. I think we're going to need to give it a little bit more than that 35. I think that's obviously wasn't enough to... we'll put it at 38, see if that helps. it seems to be holding a slightly better 37. So going down the 40s. And coming back a bit. It's settling down. Okay, that's settling down. Now a couple of other control blocks. This one at the front. Now this is going to be our collision avoidance. Now we've got no obstacles here. There's two types of obstacles could be in front of you. One is another ship. You could have another ship in front of you, which basically is you need to avoid. Or it could be in this new environment, you know, a land object, you know, one of these underwater mountains, for want of a better word. So what I tend to do is have a control block facing forwards. Now the forward facing means that if you were standing behind it, you can see the dials, so this is the facing forward part of it. You can also see which way is facing forward by the arrow. See the arrow on the blue block? So forward is the direction of the arrow. So what we're going to do is set this block here to say if there is an object in front of it, 50 meters in front of it, then set the hydrofoils to go up immediately. So we're just going to have one type of effect, and that is hydrofoils up if there's something in front. So that will make it go upwards. Yeah, that's okay. Now the second one here, it is a similar factor. It's going to be a depth gauge. So in a similar vein, it's pointing downwards. So this is going to detect the ocean floor directly below the ship. So one more time, if there is an object within, we can set a distance. We're going to set 10 meters on this. So it never gets closer to the floor than 10 meters. Then set the hydrofoils to plus 45. So again, we will raise out of the water if it, I think that's a bit much. We'll just do 30. 35 we found is a good one. So that will make it pop up. So this will detect the ground just below it and also directly in front. So this will keep it hopefully within 10 meters of any object from underneath or in front of it. Now we can do the same at the rear, just to stop the rear collapsing on anything. So if object in front is 10 meters, then set the hydrofoils to plus 45. So that's now the bigger your ship, you might need 35. I think we said we were gonna do it, 35. The bigger your ship, the more of these you might want to have dotted on along the length of the ship potentially. So what have we got here? Is that, it's not, it seems to be going down, or does it keep on setting itself? No, we're going down, up and down. So the ship is porpoising a little bit, but we're okay with that. It's got a speed of 13.3, which is not too bad. Sail it as the Eel subscale. Now the only thing we haven't done yet so far, and I'll bring it out here, is we haven't set up the missiles. So let's just quickly set up the missiles and then we can have it attack something. Let's see how it goes. So let's see, these forward missiles, we're just gonna have them short range thruster, infrared. We'll leave them with that target. We need a one turn. So we'll have a one turn there. Infrared makes sense on the, we're going to have a delay, because if it's below water, we might want a 3 second delay just before they start firing, just for it to breach the water. We might put that down to two second delay. Short range thruster. We'll put the fin there. I like the fins right next to the thruster. Don't know if it has an effect, but we'll put the one turn there. Right, let's go back. Infrared needed here. Explosive warhead. Yeah, we'll go with an explosive warhead. Target precision guidance. I don't think we need that target precision. We're going to go for a very basic, so we'll put the one turn in that position. We'll put a second fin in and maybe two fuel tanks. That should give us a range of about 500 meters, give or take. and we'll set that to a designable meter or items. Now we'll have to set up the controller here, so it's minimum range. We won't set a minimum range, but we'll set a maximum range. I'm going to say 500 at the moment, roughly 500. And also, this is going to only attack targets which are on the surface. Maximum altitude, we won't worry about the other settings. I think that would be fine. Now our big torpedoes in the front. Now we haven't got to worry about adding any restrictions on that. Our big torps here, where are they? Okay, right, so these are going to be slightly longer range, not too massively long range, but longer range. So we will have a whole load of propellers. We'll start with the guidance, so it's going to be we'll start with the propellers. So this is a 12, so we're going to need a good number of propellers. We will make this generally attack surface vessels primarily, because the enemy, and we'll work out if it ever needs to go for underwater vessels, but I don't think there is many at the moment. So we'll have 6 torpedo propellers, 6 fins, and 3 fuel tanks. That should make it go about, I think, about 800 meters or so. We will now have 1 ballast tank, but it's not going to be very deep. It's only going to be about 4 meter depth. That just stops it breaching. And we will put a regulator. So now we've got our, might not need the regulator actually. We'll put a 1 turn there. So that's 1 turn, and we'll just put it in the right direction. We will use an infrared guidance. Now the rest of this is explosives. So first of all, a proximity fuse, and we're going to put a fragment on the front. Is an armor piercing fragment, and the rest of it we're just going to put explosive. I like explosives. It's big boom. So this is going to be a big explosive with a fragmentation, lots of fins, turns fast, goes fast, reasonable range. Yeah, I like that. We'll go with that. We'll see how that performs. We will need to set some little restrictions. Now, well, at the moment I don't know the exact range it's going to go for, but let's see, where's the controller? Controllers are over here somewhere. There we are. We will set that at a minimum range. It's going to have a minimum range. There's no point in shooting at something less than, say, about 200, I think. And maximum range of, we'll set it at 1,000 for the moment. See how, if that will attack at something at 1,000. And it doesn't go out of the thing, so it's a maximum altitude of about 5. Now the reason I'm not setting that as 0 is the altitude is the target of, like, the AI, and sometimes the AI on the ship is slightly above the sea. So 5 would be is it seems like a good idea to have as a target. There we go. Now are we connected? Yes, we are connected. So the only other bar is our AI. Let's set up our AI quickly. We won't worry about the target prioritization at the moment. Naval AI. So we want this to head straight for someone. So the angle is going to be just 10 degrees. So it's just slightly off center. We want it to head straight for them, straight underneath. We want the minimum range at which point they start turning to be about 100 meters. So they'll go close as quick as possible to 100 meters, then turn around. Let's see. Below 500 meters, which is going to be the range of our missiles, it'll go at a slight angle. And, oh, sorry, no, let's get this right. 500 meters, wrong way. 500 meters at the top here. Oh dear. Let's try that again. It will turn that to face them on that 10 degrees to use its missiles. Above that, we want it to go out to about 750. So we'll see how this works. Idle approach, so broadside minimum range at 100 meters, it should start to try and turn away and turn around. Now this vehicle it's fast but doesn't turn, so it should do very wide circles. That's partially in on purpose. So let's see how this performs. We'll come out of that. See how we're going with speed. Yeah, that's not too bad. It's getting its distance. So let's just bring in something simple. Vanguard, good old Vanguard. I'll come off the missiles. There we go. So that's our missiles there. That looks quite good. Did they actually reach the target? Yes, they did. Is he going to fire again? Yes. They're quite good. Yeah, that works quite nicely. I don't know if the delay is actually positive or negative on that. Oh, no, the delay looks quite good at those sort of ranges. That one missed totally, but I think there is a minimum range would be ideal. It's not quite turning in time on some of the attacks. That's fine. We'll go with that. Yeah, there we go. So there is a minimum, but we'll leave the minimum. I want them to fire because there's always a chance they will actually attack it. Okay, so did the big missiles. I don't think the big torps actually fired. So to get them to fire, what might be worth is if I go about 1,000 away, over here somewhere. How far away am I? That's 1,200. So that's a good range. How about there? Yeah, about 1,100. That'll give us time to go in here. If I do load a vehicle, not as the deep water guard, and we'll go and find a built-in ship. Come on, load. And we'll load in something like a Marauder, I think. It's one of those standard ships I like for testing. So, load a Marauder. Resume. Okay, so we now have this Marauder. It's a little bit low, but hopefully if we go back to our ship, let's see. So there, find his missile. Cool. I want to see these, how they do. Come off so we can just follow the missiles. Now they may go for this, the remains of the Vanguard, which would be a bit annoying, but I want him to go for the Marauder. But let's see how it does. There's the small missiles. That's going for the Vanguard, which is fine. The remains of the, where's those bloody missiles gone? There they go. Okay, we'll follow them now. A, will they reach the range? They're quite fast. And they're very manoeuvrable. With all those fins and torpedoes. And how much of a boom do they make? They took a fair old chunk. That's a fair old chunk that just got taken out of there. And there's more coming in as we speak. And now the small missiles come in. Yeah, okay, they're right. They work. Excellent. So, I'll just let him destroy that. Then we will hopefully do our next little session. So he's quite happily circling around there, going up and down a little bit on the height. So the height isn't perfect, I must admit, but as I say, that may be beneficial. It's fun to watch as well anyway, in my view. There we go, there's the Marauder, big boom. This is only a little small scout as such, so that's always handy. Let's just try this new thing. So if I go hold that, I can go to the info. Oh, that's so much easier. It'd be so much easier in the campaign when we're working on that. Trying to work out what ships are, I can just hold the Q button down. Lovely. Okay, just letting that finish off. Yes, that's taken that out. Okay, we'll just take him out the surface so we can get a picture. So, what is the cost, etc., of this ship now? And we'll just get him out of the water. is continuing to fire, which is cool. Don't mind that. Come on, out the water, out the water. There we go. Let's find a nice position for our shot. There we go. So this will be our showing that the weapon's firing. And just need to go there, a little bit back. Oh, getting the screenshot just perfect is a problem. Okay, there we go. Let's try that one there. That'll do for the Steam Workshop, I think. Okay, just as a quick bit, review. The RP ended up being a lot higher than I wanted, and also the metal. So this became a bit bigger a ship than expected. Some of that is the lead blocks, etc. So, you know, it's not as cheap as I would have liked. But it has done what I wanted, which is a fast underwater ship, and hopefully you saw how these were created. So, hopefully that was helpful to some people. Hopefully I will find this on the Steam Workshop, and I'll put a link into the video down below where you can get it or check up on my Steam Workshop profile. But until next time, please click on the like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and I will next be possibly looking at the campaign again. I think just getting a little bit more in there, or adjusting some more subs and doing some more testing. If there's anything you'd like to see done, builds done, or some more subs, or some more testing of some description, please let me know, and in the comments below. Until then, have fun.